हेलो फ्रेंड, वंस अगेन आई एम रश्मि वारंकर फ्रॉम AW एकेडमी गांधीनगर पुणे। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड विद द नाउन एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ नाउन इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। नाउ फ्रॉम हियर इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम प्रोनाउन, द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच। शब्दांच्या जातीमधली सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच आहे प्रोनाउन। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। इफ आई वॉन्ट टू स्पीक ऑन माय बेस्ट फ्रेंड, so if I am saying my best friend is Snehal, Snehal is a polite girl, Snehal is a honest girl, Snehal comes on time in school, Snehal does her homework, Snehal helps me in my study, Snehal, I am repeating the name Snehal. But if I don't want to repeat the name of the Snehal, mala jar ekada noun repeat karayche nahi, if I don't want to repeat a noun, then I can use pronoun instead of noun. So I will use Snehal is my best friend, she is a polite girl, she comes in a school on time, she helps me in study, she is a very good human being, right? So I am not repeating Snehal again. So SHG she is a pronoun used instead of noun. So what is the definition of the pronoun? The word which can be used instead of noun. Noun cha nava cha aivaji jo apan ekada shabd vaparto, that is called as pronoun. Suppose I want to say my favorite cricketer. Okay, I want to say some lines for my favorite cricketer. So I will say my favorite cricketer is Sachin Tendulkar. Sachin Tendulkar is a very good batsman. Sachin Tendulkar is a very good human being. So I am repeating here the name of Sachin Tendulkar, but I don't want to repeat the name again and again. So I will use the pronoun of Sachin, that is he, right? So I will say Sachin Tendulkar is my favorite cricket player. He is the best cricketer. He is a very good human being, right? So I am not repeating here Sachin again and again. So नावाची पुनरावृत्ती म्हणजे एखाद्या नावाचं रिपीटेशन, टू अवॉइड द रिपीटेशन ऑफ द नाउन प्रोनाउन्स आर यूज. फॉर एक्झाम्पल ही, शी, इट, दे, दॅट अँड सो मेनी, देर आर सो मेनी प्रोनाउन्स. ओके, सो आय होप यू अंडरस्टँड वॉट इज प्रोनाउन. प्रोनाउन इज अ वर्ड विच कॅन बी यूज इन्स्टीड ऑफ नाउन. नावाच्या ऐवजी वापरला जाणारा शब्द म्हणजे प्रोनाउन. प्रोनाउन कॅन बी फर्स्ट पर्सन, सेकंड पर्सन, थर्ड पर्सन, राईट? इफ आय एम सेईंग आय, इट इज अ फर्स्ट पर्सन. इफ आय एम सेईंग यू, युअर्स, इट इज अ सेकंड पर्सन. इफ आय एम सेईंग ही इज, हर, इट इज अ थर्ड पर्सन. नाव द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच इज ऍब्जेक्टिव्ह. ऍब्जेक्टिव्ह म्हणजे विशेष. ऍब्जेक्टिव्ह इज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच. ऍब्जेक्टिव्ह इज अ वर्ड विच गिव्ज मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट नाउन अँड प्रोनाउन. Words which give more information about noun and pronouns are called as adjectives. For example, a beautiful girl. Girl is a common noun, but beautiful word is giving more information about the girl. So beautiful is giving more information about the noun. So beautiful will be a adjective. For example, a tall boy. Right, boy is a noun, but tall is giving more information about that boy. Nila hai par kaisa hai, uncha hai, so tall will be the adjective of that boy. Smart girl. Girl is a common noun, but the word smart is giving more information about the girl, but girl is a noun. So smart word is giving more information about this noun, so smart will be the adjective here. Smart have an adjective. Beautiful girl. Mulgi hai, pan kashi sundar. Beautiful word is giving more information about the noun, and that is girl. Girl is a common noun. So beautiful word is giving more information about the common noun, that is girl, so beautiful will be a adjective? Adjectives of quality. If a word is showing quality of that word, then it is an adjective of quality. For example, here beautiful girl will be appreciated. Sundar, it is a quality. A tall boy, boy hai, kaisa hai, kaisa hai, tall hai, is tall. So tall is a, tall is quality. So adjectives of quality, it shows what type of the thing. The adjectives of quantity. Adjectives of quantity shows the quantity of the thing. Some, thodi si, little, thodi si, much, moti, enough, pure si. So it shows the quantity of the things. After that, adjectives of number, it shows how many things are there. One ball, two ball, three balls, four balls. Ball is a noun. But one, ball ahe, but kiti ahe, ek ahe. So one representing more information, one is giving more information about the ball. Ball ahe, but kiti ahe, ek ahe. So one will be the adjective, it will be the adjective of number. Sometimes it shows the order. For example, he came first in the class. So class one is first will be the adjective of second, third, fourth. Yes, sir, what I want adjectives. After that, demonstrative adjectives. If I want to say this book, hips, it shows kiti antara ho raha hai. This book hai, what the heck is book? That book, it shows that book is far, book dur hai. This book, he pustak, pustak. So demonstrative adjectives point out a person or thing concerned. That pain, that person, the person na point out kare. That person matlab to ha to person. This pain matlab ha pain. Pain is a noun, but this is giving more information about this pain. So this will be the adjective of demonstrative. After that, possessive adjective. Possessive adjectives. My, your, his, her, its, you. Our, your. These are the possessive adjectives. And the last is interrogative adjectives. Adjectives that are used with noun. Ashe adjective, ashe visheshan je noun sabat use kela jate, nava sabat use kela jata. For asking question, ashe adjectives जे क्वेश्चन विचारण्यासाठी नावासोबत वापरले जातात दॅट आर कॉल्ड एज इंट्रोगेटिव्ह एडजेक्टिव्ह एडजेक्टिव्ह विच आर यूज विथ नाव आज क्वेश्चन आर कॉल्ड एज इंट्रोगेटिव्ह एडजेक्टिव्ह फॉर एक्झाम्पल विच पेन इज युअर्स पेन इज अ नाव बट विच इज अ एडजेक्टिव्ह पेन कोणता पेन सो विच वर्ड इज गिविंग मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट पेन कोणता पेन राईट So there are six types of adjective. So here we have completed with noun, pronoun and noun adjective. Now we will see what is verb. Verb means a word which shows the action or state. It is called as verb. Asa verb, asa shabd, jo ekhadi action dakhavto. He reads. To vachto. Vachnyachi kay? Action. She walks. Ti chalte. चालण्याची काय ऍक्शन आय टीच मी शिकवते शिकवण्याची काय ऍक्शन सो द एनी वर्ड इफ इट इज वर्ड इफ द वर्ड इज शोईंग एनी ऍक्शन इट इज कॉल्ड ऍज अ वर्ड आय वॉन्ट अ पेन मला पेन पाहिजे वॉट पाहिजे सो इट इज अ स्टेट मला पाहिजे आय वॉन्ट पेन आय एम रनिंग मी धावत आहे सो धावण्याची माझी काय प्रक्रिया सुरू देर आर फाईव्ह टाईप्स ऑफ वर्ड First is a regular verb, second is an irregular verb, third is a transitive verb, fourth is an intransitive verb, fifth is a helping verb. First of all, we will see what is mean by regular verbs. So, she verbs, ki janta second and third form create karne sakhi, ed's of upayog kela jate, that are called as regular verbs. For example, call, 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 move, move, prepare, prepared, prepared. राईट दीज आर रेग्युलर वर्ब रेग्युलर वर्ब असे असतात की ज्यांचा सेकंड आणि थर्ड फॉर्म बदलवायचा की फक्त त्यांना ईडी लावावं लागते जस्ट बस दॅट आर कॉल्ड ॲज regular verb. Now irregular verb. Regular verbs are the words which second and third forms are different from first form. We cannot derive the second and third form by attaching ed to them. त्यांना फक्त ed attach करून आपण त्यांचा second and third form बनवू शकत नाही. So that are called as irregular verb. For example, go, went, gone. Go is the first form, went is the second form, gone is the third form. So आपण याला ed go ला ed ने लावू शकतो. So go, went, gone. Here. So these are called as irregular verb. Been, gone, gone. So these are called as irregular. रेग्युलर वर्ब ज्यांचा सेकंड अँड थर्ड फॉर्म इडी लावून बनते दॅट आर रेग्युलर वर्ब. ज्यांचा सेकंड अँड थर्ड फॉर्म इडी लावून बनू शकत नाही दॅट आर इरेग्युलर वर्ब. आफ्टर दॅट ट्रान्झिटिव्ह वर्ब. ट्रान्झिटिव्ह वर्ब्स आर द वर्ब विच रिक्वायर्स ऑब्जेक्ट इन द सेंटेन्स टू कम्प्लीट देअर मिनिंग. ट्रान्झिटिव्ह वर्ब म्हणजे असे वर्ब की ज्यांचा अर्थ पूर्ण होण्यासाठी त्यांना ऑब्जेक्टची गरज असते, त्याच्याशिवाय ते कम्प्लीट होऊ शकत नाही. फॉर एक्झाम्पल बघा, अबू मेड अ फाईट. अबू मेड, अबूने बदललं, इतपर्यंत जर सेंटेन्स ठेवलं तर सब्जेक्ट प्लस वर्ब इट विल नॉट बी कम्प्लीट सेंटेन्स. हिअर मेड वर्ब इज डिपेंड अपॉन अ काइंड ऑफ. अबूनी बनवली, काय बनवली, काइंड. सो काइंड इज अ ऑब्जेक्ट. सो हिअर this verb is depend on this object for the completion of meaning or for completion of the sentence that called as transitive verb. त्याला मराठी सकर्मक क्रियापद असे. आफ्टर दॅट इनट्रान्झिटिव्ह वर्ब, ज्या वर्बला ऑब्जेक्टची गरज पडत नाही, ऑब्जेक्ट नसलाही तरी त्यांचा जो अर्थ आहे तो पूर्ण होते. The verb which does not require object to complete their meanings are called as intransitive verbs. For example, the vendor cries. Feri wala rada hota. Subject plus verb. Kaise for object hai ka? So here the verb cry. Radnyachi ji kriya hai. It is does not depend upon object. So here it is called as transitive. The chair broke. Kurti tutli. Broke is a verb. Is there some object hai ka? No. Here is no object. So the sentence does not depend upon object for its completion. It is called as intransitive verb. The verb which does not depend upon object for the completion of the meaning, for the completion of the sentence, is called as transitive. After that, helping verbs. There are two types of helping verbs. Some are primary auxiliaries and some are modal auxiliaries. So primary auxiliaries are used to make tenses and questions. जेव्हा आपण क्वेश्चन when we prepare question, when we ask question of when we prepare tenses at that time, these verbs behave as a main verb. First, याच्यामध्ये टू बीचे रूप आहेत, टू चे बी चे रूप आहेत, हॅवचे रूप आहेत आणि टू चे रूप आहेत. सो एम इज आर द फॉर्म्स ऑफ बी. हॅव हॅज हॅड आर द फॉर्म्स ऑफ हॅव अँड डू डज डीड आर द फॉर्म्स ऑफ डू. दीज ऑक्झिलरीज आर यूज फॉर प्रिपेरिंग क्वेश्चन्स अँड टेक्स्ट. आफ्टर दॅट मॉडेल ऑक्झिलरीज. मॉडेल ऑक्झिलरी ऑलवेज कम with a main verb. They does not appear separately. They separately appear only. They always come with a main verb. They may be main verbs over there. For example, I shall come with you. Shall is a modal auxiliary. But shall comes with the come. And come here is a main verb. So, हा main verb. आणि हा त्यासोबत आलेला दुसरा verb. So, it is a modal auxiliary. Modal auxiliaries are always come with a main verb in a sentence. They always appears, modal auxiliaries always appears with the main verb in a sentence. They does not appear separately in the sentence. So this is all about the verb. There are five types of verb: regular verbs, irregular verbs, transitive verbs, intransitive verbs, and helping verbs. In start with thank you. Thank you so much. I hope you all are enjoying. I hope you all are understanding or keep learning.